sort of become one. Her music is my music, and my voice is her voice.
Hey there, this is Mr. Icarus, and welcome to an exclusive preview of Metal Hellsinger. What is a Metal Hellsinger exactly? Well, imagine Doom Eternal and a rhythm shooter involved in a teleporter accident. That is essentially what you get here with Metal Hellsinger, a rhythm shooter where the more in sync you are with the rhythm, the more intense the music will become and the more damage you can deal. When it comes to the soundtrack providing said rhythm, it certainly doesn't hurt that it is appropriately metal as all heck, featuring a pretty impressive roster of icons of the genre, such as Trivium's Matt Heafy, Arch Enemy's Alyssa White Gloves, and Lamb of God's Randy Blythe. Yep, they're not doing anything by half measures here, but before I get any deeper, I have to say big thanks to Metal Hellsinger for sponsoring this video and granting me this early opportunity to take a look at what makes this game tick ahead of the debut of its demo during Steam Next Fest, which is slated to begin June 13th. But in the meantime, feel free to check out the game by clicking the link in the description below. Right, let's get into this. From what I can tell, the idea of the rhythm shooter is still something that's very nascent in terms of its genesis. Barely even a handful of games in my memory have even taken advantage of the concept. But even then, it taps into something very primal, very satisfying, and I think the best way to illustrate that is by firing a shotgun to the beat of a song. It's something that many of us will have done before in various other games with banging soundtracks, but here it is crucial to how you perform. Pulling the trigger as close as possible to the beat will not only net you additional damage, but also additional score, which you'll see tallied up in the top right hand corner. You'll also see a multiplier in the middle of the screen there. That will tick all the way up to 16x, depending on how good you are at pulling off your actions and kills to the beat, and it's more than just a way to pursue a high score, because once you breach that 16x multiplier, you'll actually find that the vocals kick into the track, amp up the intensity, delivering this wonderful additional surge of adrenaline into the gameplay. There's also ultimates. Those are special abilities which are unique to each weapon. In the case of the shotgun, it's an even bigger shotgun blast, but as you progress to other weapons and deal with the particular quirks, you'll also discover the particular ultimates too. These are triggered thanks to the orange bar on the bottom right of the HUD. Once that fills, naturally, it's ready. And they all have delightful names that honestly wouldn't sound out of place in the middle of a JoJo arc, such as The Big Goodbye and Murder of Crows. But crucially, they're there to help you deliver that punctuation mark of damage, with some of them providing a big beefy dollop of death, or in the case of the revolvers here, generating a secondary shade that can target enemies on your behalf. Have I also mentioned that there's a folksy narrator that takes the form of a flaming demonic skull that you can use to fire fireballs at your enemies with an ult that charges and then turns your enemies into explosive barrels? Yes, that's a thing as well, and that's not even its ultimate. That actually calls lightning down from the sky to smite your enemies. Neat. And considering I've got this far with the weapons, I might as well show you what happens with the sword's ultimate, which allows you to strike on double time. So, weaponry, metal is all heck. Soundtrack, metal is all heck. Story, guess what? Also, metal is all heck. It's the kind of stuff that you'd read in the liner notes of a metal concept album. And that, if anything, gets to the crux of Metal Hellsinger, in my opinion. You're essentially playing through an interactive album here. One that will take you through 8 distinct hells in its final release in pursuit of vengeance against the Red Judge of all hells. It's delightfully overblown stuff. There's more to it than simply that, but man, you gotta appreciate dedication to the gimmick. And it really is filtered through everything here. The level design, the enemy design. I really appreciate how certain elements outside of your movement or shooting also sync up with the beat. The pyro, for example, that flares in certain parts of a level, or even the beat of unholy light within certain enemies. It really adds to the immersion. It really makes it easy for you to slip into that flow state that just makes you feel like one with the rhythm. It certainly doesn't hurt that this game seems to be in pretty experienced hands either. The development team here is headed up by creative director David Goldfarb. He's got over 20 years experience. He's worked on things like the Battlefield games, particularly Bad Company 2 and Battlefield 3. He's also worked on Mirror's Edge, which was pretty experimental in its own right when that released, Payday 2, Killzone, and it's just always exciting to see someone apply that degree of experience to an idea that most of it probably viewers kind of left field, kind of unusual, a little different. Personally, I think the future for Metal Hellsinger looks really promising, even on the basis of this demo, which again is going to be available at Steam Next Fest from the 13th to the 20th of June. It's reasonably short, it's not going to take you all that long to get through, but it certainly begs for a degree of replayability, especially when you consider that high score leaderboard that gives you your ranking at the end of a level. Really makes me want to go back in there and see if I can do things a little smoother, a little better, take advantage of more combo opportunities, and honestly, if anything, it reminds me of arcade mode from Doom 2016. That mode was just like absolute catnip to me, so yeah. Looking forward to whatever fresh hell's Metal Hellsinger will drag us to come its full release. But in the meantime, as before, if you want to check out this game, the link is in the description below. Feel free to add it to your wish lists. And in any case, I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this preview. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and until next time, this has been Mr. Icarus. Thank you very much for watching. Icarus out.